Good morning, this is Mission Control Houston. Welcome and thank you for joining us for today's edition of ISS Update this Wednesday, February 6. Before the Expedition 34 kicked off its day overnight, the Kibo robotic arm was used to inspect several of the experiments on the exposed facility on the front porch of the Japanese laboratory before being deactivated for the day. The crew kicked off the day with the first of two daily planning conferences with ground controllers around the world to review the day's activities and plan for the next set of tasks. Station Commander Ford and Flight Engineers Hadfield and Marshburn had participated in a conference this morning to discuss upcoming cargo operations for the arrival of the next SpaceX Dragon resupply ship that is targeted for launch to the station early next month. Commander Ford then began to load new software to the computers of the science experiment Express Rack 3. Commander Ford also will spend some time performing some maintenance work to change out a recycle tank of the onboard water recovery system. The water recovery system recycles urine, sweat, and condensation into drinkable water for the crew. And Flight Engineer Hadfield continued this week's work within the microgravity science glove box that is used for performing contained science experiments, conducting more test runs with a science experiment known as InSpace 3. This is an inside look of that experiment that looks at the changes of physical properties of colloids and fluids in response to magnetic fields. The research has a possible technological application in structure design here on Earth. Structures such as bridges and buildings to better withstand earthquake forces. Flight Engineer Marshburn has been working this morning on the periodic inspection and maintenance of the portable fire extinguishers, portable breathing apparatus, and the extension hose T-kits. And meanwhile, on the Russian side of the house, Russian flight engineers Oleg Novitsky, Yevgeny Tarelkin, and Roman Romanenko divide their day between hardware inventory, maintenance, and several science experiments, including the bar experiment, which looks at methods and instruments for detecting the location of a loss of pressure aboard the station, as well as the Matryoshka experiment that studies the radiation dose types and rates that relate to the health of crew members on long-duration missions. Flight Engineer Novitsky also took photos as part of the SENER study that examines the oceans below. It documents their characteristics and then correlates that info to certain bioproductive areas that impact the fishing industry. This is Mission Control Houston.